friends, for joining us on Africa Talk Show. I am Princess Asha Okojie Odiji, host of Let's Talk Africa. On air with me is my co-host, Kenny Odugbimi.
Morning, everybody. It's me, Kenny K, and I'm holding it down from Maryland, United States of America. Welcome to Africa Talk Radio.
Joining us, Kenny, is a special guest, the Honorable Prince Albert Okojie, who is the son of the famous King Ogbidi Okojie, the Onojie of Uromi Kingdom. He's a foundation member of the action group under the leadership of Chief Obafemi Awolowo, former member of the Nigerian Broadcasting Corporation, parliamentary secretary, commissioner, and junior minister of Midwestern Region, now known as Edo State. He's also a philanthropist who has helped many sons and daughters to actualize their dreams. Over the years, he has earned a galaxy of awards, including Commander of the Order of the Niger, an award given by the Office of the President of Nigeria to honor Nigerians who have rendered service to benefit the nation. Mm-hmm. And, of course, he's my one and only daddy. How you doing, Honorable Sir?
Fine. Thank God today.
Yeah, welcome to the show, sir. It's a pleasure meeting you, finally. Get to talk to the backbone behind the Africa Talk thing. I mean, she must have had some quality backing with the upbringing and everything to be able to produce somebody that is so, so vibrant in whatever she does. Welcome to the show, sir. It's a pleasure having you on.
I would take that as a compliment, Kenny. Where does the name of Okojie originate from, and why was your dad, your father, King Ogbidi Okojie, called the white son of Olokun, as history has it?
Well, the name Okojie came from an Onojie of Uromi called Okolo. Okolo was one time Onojie of Uromi who gave birth to Okojie the first. That was where he got the name. He got the name from his dad. His dad was a king of Uromi, and he was shot dead by the British Empire when the war for Uromi ensued.
Wow.
He was the Onojie of Uromi when the British people came in, and he was shot dead.
Oh, okay.
That is Okolo, yes. Okolo is the father of Okojie the First.
Honorable Sir, why would they kill your grandfather? What was the reason?
Yes, it was during the struggle between the British and the native authority of Uromi. You know, the British invaded Uromi in a war, and they wanted to take over the administration of Ishan.
So I guess
the
he was trying to stop them.
And then he was killed.
Well, that's really a shock to me, because it's like this oppression has been going on for a long time. This sort of aggression happened to my own family, you know, down the line. It's just absurd now that we are beginning to talk about things like this. It's history, but at the same time, it just shows you how much we as black people have struggled to have, you know, control over our own country, you know.
That was struggle between the native and the British. British was an occupation force, and the government of Okojie Okoro was on. They came to take the government from him. That was the struggle. That's why he lost his life. And then they died his first son, which is Okojie the First, to Calabar.
Slavery at that time in Uromi, did they have people that were enslaved at? Yes.
There was war, there was fighting at Uromi between the British and the Uromi people, and their leader was killed at Tukoni by the British, who then captured his first son and exiled him to Calabar in 1900.
His Royal Highness Aslim Edunoji had his 20th coronation, as you may remember, Kenny, last week in Uromi. After the death of your father, King Ogbidi, how many kings have been crowned, and how is the present king related to you, Honorable Sir?
Yes. My father was Okojie, who was supposed to have been born in 1836. He ruled up to 1944. He died. And then his first son, Uwagbale, took over from him. Uwagbale. Then after Uwagbale's death, the Onojie that took over from him was Edenoje first. Then okay. after Adenoje, then Omerime. After Adenoje, Omerime. Then mm-hmm. after Omerime is the one now, they are Aslem Odalari, President Onojie, Aslem. Which is from my father's time is now number five. Aslem is number five.
Oh, okay. Okay, so there's
number five Onojie of the throne, yes.
Honorable Sir. I'm kind of curious about King Ogbidi Okojie. They said he was highly influential in Ishan and Agbo, Sogbinin and stuff. I mean, well, you mentioned earlier on that he was being exiled in Calabar, Benin, Ibadan. How was he able to escape? I mean, each time he was arrested, we heard that he got out one way or the other. Do you have an idea
yes.
of how
so he was? After the death of his father, he was exiled to Calabar as a prince. Then the Uromi people agitated that they wanted their king. So he was brought back in 1901 to be Onojie of Uromi.
Oh, okay.
Then
Yes,
he was on throne from 1901 till 1918 when he was exiled to Benin, which he did not attend. He was exiled to Benin, yes. He was exiled to Benin. They took him to Benin, all right, settled him in Benin, but due to his wonderful power, he emanated to Uromi again. They didn't know when he came back to Uromi. He was at Uromi till 1920.
Do you have an idea how he was able to escape?
He was a man of many fronts. He can escape anywhere. He followed them to Benin. He was in Benin. Then he came back to Uromi on his own. He was a wonderful man. He can become a tree. He can come to market like a woman. He can.
Wow.
The myth was discovered in 1926 when they rearrested him and sent him to Ibadan. In 1936, they released him in 1931, August, came back to Uromi and became Onojie again in 1944, and he died.
He just disappeared and reappeared, and every time he gets back, he becomes a king again. You know, that's something.
Yes.
That's
something. He was behind his first son. His first son knew that his father did not go to exile because he sees him, he confronts his son, and he talked to him, he advised him.
Wow.
He was around. But
they
saw him in 1926, and then there he surrendered and agreed to follow them to exile to Ibadan.
Yes,
doesn't that remind you of a lot of the rings and movies?
A human being turning into a tree, turning into a woman.
I can turn into a small river.
Oh, my God. Princess, I hope some of that power was passed down to you. You should show me how to do that.
We didn't achieve that power. We didn't. We were too young. We couldn't copy him.
It was not like somebody told you. You were aware about this whole thing happening, unfolding. Something that you wasn't told.
I saw a lot of his performance. I was born 1922. I was born 1922. I was 22 years when he died.
Honorable Sir, King Ogbidi Okojie was not just a king, but he was a supreme judge.
He was made a judge. He was made a judge over Odishan, Abo, and the Ora. He was in charge of criminal court.
Oh, it's super
very
good.
Huge,
I mean,
tall, yellow man. Very huge, yes.
Wow.
He was like a giant. Yeah.
I mean, we heard that he built schools, roads, and supported a lot of education. How was he able to, like, accomplish all that in his time? I mean, despite the fact that he was going on exile and coming back, going on exile, coming back, and, you know. So, I mean, how was he able to do all that?
Well, the British recorded it themselves. He was a powerful man. Even when he was exiled to Benin, the Oba here had to submit to him. The Oba met him and sustained friendship with him. But he was not friendly with the Oba because the Oba was monitoring him, telling the British. So the Oba had his own share of his power. And that's why he was removed from Benin to Ibadan. He tried to take over ruling from Benin Oba. When he got to Ibadan, the Oba of Ibadan went to him and submit his cooperation. I said, I understand you were at Benin, and since we are not well, but here, I give you the right to rule over part of Ibadan. He gave me part of Ibadan to rule, and there was peace at Ibadan. He didn't trouble the Ibadan Oba, and he was quite happy there.
Did your dad have children while he was in Ibadan?
He had children while he was at Ibadan. Some of the wives went to him and stayed with him. At Calabar, I had time to have children at Calabar. He died and left about 300 children.
Oh,
oh
my God.
Were they all born by him? I mean, they were his biological children?
All the wives that stayed with him were born, his children were born by himself. He kept them in the harem, big compound, just like a village.
So that brings the question, Honorable Sir, about how many wives he had. Because when you read about King Ogbidi, it says that he had, you know, over, supposed to be 100 wives. So does that support that argument or... It doesn't.
The 100 wives were a total women by his grandfather, Okolo. Among those 100, supposed 100, the wives of Okolo were there, and his own were there.
I'm not clear on that, sir, please. You said that they were his father's wife and also his wives altogether. I mean,
the law required that after the death of his father, he should retain his father's wife. He didn't have children by the women of his father. He didn't have children.
Okay.
Well, most of the children were his mates. They were his mates. But the Lord forbids that me and Onojie's wife, they cannot marry somebody else.
Okay.
So they have to remain, So they have to remain. Including the wife of Okolo. Okolo's father. Okolo had a father who had women who were now old, but they were in the compound. Okolo himself had wives. They are in the compound. Okojie had wives. They are in the compound. So those are the total women you call it their wives.
His wife. Okay.
Wow.
So that must have been a misconception in the things that we read. It wasn't really stated clearly that he inherited wives. According to what I understand, he was like inheriting the wives from his, I suppose, from his grandfather which he was obliged to take care of alongside with his own wife. So I guess that's what they counted.
Okay.
It's all clear now.
You get it correct.
Your father left a legacy, as we all know already. His fulfillment for renewed independence for Black Africa and Nigeria. Late Chief Anthony Namoro, who initiated self-government that led to Nigerian independence, you know, was, of course, his grandson, as well as... Cardinal Anthony Olubomi Okojie, who is also the first Asian cardinal. How are you? Are we related, or should I say, are you related to Anthony Olubomi Okojie? Let me rephrase that, because his name is spelled, his last name is O-K-O-G-I-E.
Okay.
Whereas yours is O-K-O-J-I-E. How are you related, and what type of men are these people?
We all related. Nahoro is the son of his daughter. One of his daughters, called Enibokun, is the mother of Anthony Nahoro. And Anthony Nahoro, who was a politician, is the grandson of my father, Okojie first. The Olubomi of Okojie is the Catholic denomination. Okojie was... His father was a custom officer, son of my father, called Michael Okojie.
Okay.
That one worked for customs. That was for customs and married a Yoruba woman who bore him Anthony Olubomi Okojie, who is now that's the grandson of my father, too. And now it's from his daughter. Okojie, the Catholic, is from his father's son.
Okay. So for the O-K-O-G-I-E, as pronounced Okojie, is the same as Okojie.
Okojie. He used Yoruba pronunciation to spell that name. That's Yoruba pronunciation. It's J-I-E, Okojie. That is the understanding name of the Onojie. But the bishop altered his own to be Yoruba pronunciation, Okojie. It's not Okojie, it's Okojie.
Okay.
J-I-E is the pronunciation, yes. We left that for him because his mother was a Yoruba woman. We didn't argue. We allowed him to retain the name.
So whenever you see Okojie
and Okojie,
from Okojie, there is a co-relationship. So that means it's the same family tree.
It's the same Okojie. All over the world, it's Okojie, J-I-E. But this Yoruba woman mutated the language by pronunciation, and that's how the son took the spelling as Okojie. There's no Okojie, it's Okojie. Yoruba pronunciation is different from our pronunciation.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
But it's the same Okojie, all true. The same Okojie.
Oh,
Let me go back to history, Honorable Sir. Okojie, where did they come from? What was the lineage? Are they probably Benin? Because sometimes I hear that, you know, the Ishans come from Benin. Is that true? Is that it's a true fact that Okojie came from Benin Kingdom?
You see, there are two types of people in Ishan. Okay. The aborigines, the earlier people in Ishan were Urobos. They were Urobos.
Really?
They were robots. Yes. The founders of Ishan were robots. But monarchy came to Ishan through Benin. Yeah. The people who came to Ishan when people were already in Ishan. These people were from Urobo. And so because monarchy came from Benin, the Benin rule dominates Ishan as a whole. So you'll be right to say Ishans are from Benin.
Like they say, the Benins are from Yoruba, from Ife.
Yeah, I mean, we heard that too. Benin people, they are also Yoruba from Ife.
No. Ife rather is from Benin. The Oba of Benin is the one who founded Ife. That's a long argument.
Okay.
I don't know how it has been resolved. But the Oba of Benin claimed that he gave birth to the founder of Ife. He was driven away as a number from Benin by people when he went to Ife to settle. And opened the up there, they began to speak Yoruba and live like Yoruba. But when it was time in history, he was required to come back to Benin after the settlement he had with his people. He said he was too old and sent his son to go and rule Benin. So the actual founder of Ife died in Ife, yes.
So he was a Benin man. I mean, the founder of Ife was a Benin man. So Benin origin, I mean, Ife
origin. The Benin man was Benin, was. Was an Onojie at Benin. He was an Onojie at Benin. They called him, he's Ogiso. Ogiso is the name, Ogiso.
Oh, okay.
Ogiso, somebody that comes from heaven, Ogiso. Ogiso is somebody planted by God.
Wow. We need a history book.
Starting from Okolo.
Okolo is the father of Okojie, Okolo.
Mm-hmm.
So Okolo is the father of Okojie.
Okay.
Yeah, are you working on any books? That you are a living legend yourself. You know, are you writing a book?
I'm writing a history book, but that is myself. I'm writing a book on my own. I've gone very far.
Okay.
If you want to help me, I will send it to edit it.
Oh, definitely. it will be a pleasure to be a part of that. I've learned a lot. I never knew Ife originated from Benin. I didn't know. I thought it was one of the Yoruba side. I didn't know. So, I mean, I'm getting a lot of knowledge from this. So, I mean, with a book like that, it's going to help young people like us know how a lot of things came to be and how things were done way back in the past. You know?
Yeah.
That it will be a pleasure.
Yeah, they found out Yoruba is from Benin.
I'm sure Princess would love to be a part of that book too. Definitely.
Oh yes, I'm all about culture. Honorable Sam knows that I have a passion for it, and that also brings me to this question: do we have a way of preserving history? Because I know before the British people came, we had a lot of arts, stories, culture, history, a lot of things that represented our beliefs and traditions.
We have a book written by late Dr. Okojie. I have a copy right now. Christopher Okojie. He's a doctor. He died. He was a doctor in Ishan for many years.
Okay.
I mean, we would like to lay our hands on that book, if you don't mind, sir.
Yeah, I have that book in my possession. I can make it available for us at any time.
Oh, okay.
I appreciate
you
so
much,
Honorable. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you very much, sir. Good to have you on.
Thank you.
And we hope to hear more from you and our book, sir. We'll come get our book soon.
Thank you, sir.
And I thank my listeners for taking time to listen to this great story about the history of Ogbidi Okojie. Thank you so much, Daddy. Thank you, Kenny.
Thank you.
Yeah, bye, everybody.
Remain. keys to my heart, the only one way I see. Cause I love the way you day. Without you, girl, I'm incomplete. So my baby, turn around and hold my hand. So I go show you to my mama. You make me fall in love with you. And I go show you to my papa. You make me fall in love with you. Said I go show you to my mama. You make me fall in love with you. And I go show you to my brother. You make me fall in love with you. And I go show you to my sister. You make me fall in love with you.
I want to make you be my baby mama. And I will stay around you cause you are my sunshine. Oh girl, you be the treasure that I seek. And my pillow when I sleep. Without you I'm incomplete. See, you are so fine and divine. So hold your hold my hand. Cause you are my number one. And I will show you, see. You like the moonlight that shines so bright. Baby girl, come on, hold me tight. Ooh, you like the moonlight that shines so bright. Baby girl, come on, hold me tight. You didn't make me, didn't make me.
Like a fool, and when you walk past me, it be like say you change my world. You are the apple of my eye. Whatever them say, I don't mind. You are the flower in my pot. Water on you every night.
You are so fine and divine. So go, girl, hold my hand. You are my number one, and I go show you say.
You like the moonlight that shines so bright. Baby girl, come hold me tight. Shines so bright. Baby girl, come on, hold me tight.
Show you to my mama, you make me fall in love with you. And I go show you to my brother, you make me fall in love with you. And I go show you to my sister.